Welcome to WebSense Pro. I'm your host Bilal Nasir with another Shopify how-to video. And in today's video, I'm going to teach you guys how you can add hover effect on your product images for Zoom. So you'll be having Zoom on hover effect on your product images just like this. And cool thing about this tutorial is that you won't need to install any additional app for that. I'll be showing you guys how you can do that via custom code, and it will be implemented on all of the product images for your Shopify theme. And this tutorial is for Dawn theme 7.0.1. If you want to learn, stick to the video. Don't forget to comment on the video. And if you want to learn this for how to implement on any other theme, don't forget to comment so I can create a similar tutorial for you guys. So without further ado, let's jump into the code. Okay guys, so that's how the original product page of Shopify Dawn theme looks like. So there's no hover effect on product images. And after implementing this tutorial, you will have your product page looks like this with the zoom effect. Looks cool, right? Okay, so in order to implement this, we will first go to backend of our Shopify. So I'm just gonna close this one and refresh to show you guys, as I have removed all of the codes, and that's how it's a completely fresh Dawn theme which I have installed to teach you guys how you can implement that. Okay, so I'm gonna go to the back end of my Shopify store by navigating to /admin. And from there, click on online store. And from here, as you can see, our current theme is Dawn. So I just recently downloaded it, like about 2-3 hours ago, and it's Dawn 7.0.1. So we'll be going to edit our code by clicking on these three dots and then click on edit code. Before editing the code, make sure to duplicate it and save the backup in case you're working on a live theme. So if you mess up anything with the code, you can easily revert it back. Okay, now click on edit code. And first, what we're gonna do, we will find CDN for jQuery. We'll be adding jQuery in our theme.liquid file. So that's our first step. So just Google up CDN jQuery. And from there, you will find the link on the top. And we will be needing latest version for that. So click on Magnifying. And from here, click on this copy link, copy to clipboard, it's copied. Now go to your theme.liquid file, and in our theme.liquid file, I'll just paste the jQuery CDN code which I copied from jQuery. Okay, now click on save. Now the second step is to include jQuery plugin for our zoom on hover functionality, and for that I'll upload a jQuery plugin file. So click on settings from Shopify dashboard, then go to files, and in files I'll upload the jQuery plugin. So I have that file saved on my desktop. So that's the file lightzoom.js. I'll provide a blog post link in YouTube video description where you will find all of the instructions including the file which you need to download in order to implement this. So after uploading that file, you will see that here. And I'm just gonna copy this link and I'll paste the code in src of this snippet. So just paste it here and then copy this complete code and add it to your theme.liquid file. So this basically tells Shopify that if you find the product page, please add this jQuery plugin. Okay, now copy this and paste it on your theme.liquid file. So I'm gonna go to my code editor again, and from there I will navigate to theme.liquid file and I'll copy the code. I'll paste the code which I just copied just below the jQuery code which we added. Okay, Here it is. Now click save. Okay, now we are on our third step. Third step, we will include, we will add a class in order to initialize our jQuery plugin. Okay, now go to product-thumbnail. product-thumbnail.liquid file, and in here we will find a code media.preview_image.alt. So just find this code, and above this code I'll include a class, and the class is image selector. That's we will add. You can add your custom image selector. I'm just gonna add image selector, image dash selector for now, and I'm gonna copy this and I'll search media.preview_image.alt everywhere on this file and add a class above it. Okay, media.preview_image. Just copy this. Here we have, and I'm just gonna add my class again. Class image selector. Make sure you don't do any spelling mistakes, because that's really important part of our tutorial. Class inverted commas image dash selector and then comma at the end. Same thing here. So we have this code here as well. Okay. Already added image selector. Okay, we are done. So there are 3 to 4 times where you will need to add this code, and after adding this code, hit save. After saving this file, search for global.js, and in this global.js file, scroll down to the bottom and add this JS code. And again, I'm going to add a blog post link in YouTube video description where you will find all of the codes, including the instructions which you need to follow. So that's the class which we added in our product-thumbnail.liquid file. Now our fourth step is adding this code in our global.js file. Now just copy this code and add this code in on the bottom of our global.js file. I'm just going to copy this code and in our global.js file, paste it at the bottom of the file. Click save after pasting the code. And now final step of our tutorial is to add some CSS code. Now search for base.css file. After opening that file, scroll down to the bottom and add the CSS code which I'll provide you guys. And that's our CSS code. Just copy it and paste it on the bottom of the file. And after pasting the code, hit save. And now finally, it's our time to test if our magnifying class zoom hover effect is working fine. So that's our product page. And now I'm going to hit refresh. And here we go. Our magnifying class zoom on hover effect is showing up completely fine. You can also change the size of the magnifying glass radius. So in order to do that, go to global.js file. And in here, the code which we added, you can simply change the glass size and reduce it to be smaller. So from 200, let's make it 100. And I can also decrease the zoom power. So zoom power is from 1 to 4. You can decrease it like by tapping on 1. So 1 means there will be very small zoom power. And now hit save. Now let's go back. And let's wait for it saving. Okay, it's saved now. Now go back to the product and hit hard refresh. Make sure to hard refresh, because if you have the JS file cached on your browser, it's not gonna change quickly. You will have to refresh multiple times. I have hard refresh in order to prevent that. And here you go. As you can see, our zoom effect is reduced and our radius of magnifying glass is also reduced. Now let's get it back to 3, which is the normal effect, and hit save. And after saving the file, make sure to hard refresh. And here we go. As you can see, the zoom power of our magnifying glass has been increased, and let's test it on other products as well. So let's test it on that one. And there's our product. And as you can see, it's working completely fine. Looks cool, right? Okay guys, that's it for the tutorial. If you guys want to learn how to implement that on your own theme, let me know in the comments below which theme you would like to implement this code to, and I'll definitely create a video tutorial for you guys. Until next video, have a great day.